Okie dokie. In this video, we are taking a look at using rich text with Graph CMS. This example is available on the Graph CMS examples repo over on GitHub. I'm going to download this manually with npx digit. I'll pop that into my terminal and wait for it to download. CD into the project directory and open VS Code. Before we take a look around the project, however, I'm going to install the dependencies with yarn. And while that's installing, we'll take a look around this Next.js app. So we've got an index page, and then we have a products route, which is taking a slug. Let's go to the index page first of all. Here we're importing NextLink and GraphQL client. In getStaticProps here, we define our Graph CMS GraphQL client. This is referencing the e-commerce example project over on Graph CMS. We are querying for products, product slug, and name, and those are being returned as props for the index page to use here, where we are mapping over each product in products and returning a next link with the name referencing the products route here, passing in the slug. Okay, let's go over to the products page. In here, we're importing GraphQL client and rich text from the rich text React renderer. We're defining our Graph CMS client here, which is referencing the e-commerce example project endpoint. We'll come to getStaticProps in just a minute. Let's look at getStaticPaths first of all. So we're querying for each slug in products here, and these are being returned as the params, which is what's being used in getStaticProps here. This query we have defined is taking in the params.slug here and being used in our product page query. I'm going to take a copy of this so we can look at this in the API playground over on the Graph CMS project. Let's switch over to that now. Before we go to the API playground, just going to take a look at the content. We go to product and to the trusty cap here. When we scroll down to the content, we see we've got a heading with some text with bold and underline, and we've got an unordered list. Let's take a look at that in the API playground, in that query, and add in a query variable for slug. We use our trusty cap. Okay, let's run that. Here we have our product page query for the raw data here, defining our heading, the paragraph, where it's bold and underline. That's been used by the rich text renderer over in our project here. We scroll down to our product page. Here's where we're rendering out the product name, and then we're using rich text here for the product content raw. So let's take a quick look at that in action. Use yarn dev. Go over to localhost 3000. And we'll take a look at our cap. And here we have it. Our rich text rendered product from the e-commerce example project. Okay, that's it for this one. I hope you found it useful, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.